Hey there, YouTube. Welcome to my channel. We're about halfway through the trading session in the stock market today. So we're going to start off with the broad indices and then look at some individual stocks and trade ideas, and we'll wrap up. So if you're new to the channel, we really cover technical analysis. It's all about finding trade ideas, and I just point out what I see in the charts. That's basically what this is all about. So it's not financial advice. It's not really even trading advice. It's just what I see and what I'm, how I'm positioning for trades. Leave me a thumbs up if you guys find value in this kind of content. Let's get started. And also, if you're new to technical analysis, I do have a course. Link is in the description below. So go ahead and click that link and you'll see the course. You can just sign up for that. And that'll give you the skill set to teach you how to really read these charts. It's about 5 or 6 hours worth of video training. I think it's a well worth the cost that I charge, which is very, very affordable and priced appropriately. Okay, so starting out with the triple Qs, what do we got going on? Let's look at the hourly chart. All right, we're rallying up against this resistance line right here, about 326.30. You can see that basically you've got a zone of resistance, but right there, this is previous support right there, 326. They had it held at support here. It finally broke, and when it broke, the buyer stepped in, rallied it to resistance. Broke again, they rallied it back up to resistance. Broke again, rallied it up to resistance. One thing to note is that the drops are getting less, and they are making it look like they want to push it back up through this resistance, which is possible. However, if I look at the daily chart, on the daily here, if I draw from the COVID lows of 2020 up to about right there, let's get that line drawn out. You can see you've got support here, and then we finally broke with a sell signal right there. Nice impulsive breakdown. So maybe this wants to come in and do a back test. That is possible. They might run it up. Could even make a new all-time high if they back test it up around here. That would be an objective area to take a short or add to a short. As of right now, I'm just going to continue to stick with the fact that I think the market is going to go lower and make another leg down. Next level of support, about 311.30. We're kind of in the middle of a backtest of the trend line and the first level of support. So not really a spot to take a new position. We want to see this continue to sell. Next sell signal, I think, is probably going to come on just a break of the lows, the recent lows down here about 316. And if we break that, we're likely heading right down to 311. Flipping over to the SPY, this is one of the reasons why I think tech is going to sell off. If you look at the daily chart on the SPY, coming off the March 2020 lows right here, I can probably adjust that up slightly. We held support recently right there and there. And then recently we got a breakdown of that trend line, a big sell signal. That sell signal came with negative divergence. See the negative momentum on the PPO and the RSI, how the momentum has been dropping off, or basically each new high that we've made is on less and less momentum. I teach that concept in my course, so you can see that. But there's a sell signal. And then we come up for a back test right there of that trend line, about 416.30. And since then, we've just been kind of drifting sideways. So I think we're likely going to reject and head lower. We could grind higher a little bit, then reject. I don't know exactly how it's going to play out, but we're still below resistance. And while we're below resistance, there's a higher probability that we go lower. All right, so that's how I'm trading that. Next level of support on the SPY is about 400. There's a gap right there on the daily chart. So I think we trade down to 400. That's our next level of support. IWM, same deal on IWM. You've got a daily chart here with a nice clean trend line from the March 2020 lows. You got support recently, and then we broke. There's your sell signal and a back test right now. So we're back testing. And again, I think we continue to drift lower because we're below support. Clean negative divergence. See how that's moving lower, trending lower on the momentum. And add a back test. So I think it's likely we sell off down to about 205. And that's our next level of support is about 205. So still looking for lower prices across the board in the indices. Okay, let's look at gold. So gold and gold miners, I've talked about them for weeks, months, really, recently. And they seem like a very bullish sector back, you know, really back down here is where I was getting bullish on these miners. And I talked about the, I've been talking about these miners for a while. They continue to break higher. Here's gold bullion, you know, broke yesterday above the 200-day moving average. You can see it was kind of building, grinding, and then big impulsive breakout above the 200-day. We're still holding up there. So as far as I can tell, gold just had a correction in a longer-term bull market. And, you know, you look at the weekly, you can see here's the bull market. Basically a big, huge cup and handle pattern on this weekly chart. And here's your handle, and we're breaking out to the upside. So that is going to, you know, really forecast a good size move, probably up to about 2,500 or so, 3,000 bucks in gold. As far as I can tell, we're continuing higher. All the gold miners are looking rock solid. Here's Barrick Gold. You can see coming in a little bit today. Let's look at the daily here. Little bit today, but ultimately just holding that support level at about 2482 that I've had marked out for a while. That was former resistance there. Former resistance right there. A little bit of support right in there. Not much, but it's not a very solid level. There's not a lot of resistance here, so I think we're just going to continue higher, heading up to, you know, what I can see next level about 2840, and then we got another level up here about 3050 or so, and then beyond that I think it's all-time highs. So as far as I can tell, it looks like Barrick is just going to continue trending higher, probably going to go to the all-time highs and potentially beyond. So we're going to continue to stay long on these miners. Everything looks good on these from my perspective today. Okay, let's get into, you know, some of the more exciting trades. The miners are, you know, just a longer term trending trade that, as far as I can tell, are going to just move higher over time. So we'll just let those play out. Let's look at some of these momentum stocks that are trading into resistance. Here's Lyft. Had a clear sell signal the other day. Here's your uptrend line right there. Negative divergence on the RSI and the PPO. Big sell signal right there on this daily chart. So that's your sell signal, followed by a lot more selling. Get a kickback rally right up. We filled the gap right there at 5206. And as I zoom in on the hourly, you can see what's kind of happening. They run up, pop it above. But so far, you know, looks like this is resistance and we're going to sell down. Now, yes, we could continue higher and do a full back test up to around 58, 59, depending on when we get there. But I put a little heavier weighting that we're going to actually get rejected right in here and continue lower. So on the daily, you know, if we sell off, I still think we're heading down to this 43.50 area. The 200-day moving average is down there. You can see we held support back there. So I think we get there, probably get a bounce or, you know, a bounce around that level. And the final target on this would be down at 31.90. All right. Still like that. That still looks good. We're basically at a level of resistance right now. Same with Snap. You can see Snap is downtrending recently on the daily. You can see we're making lower highs and lower lows. We do need to, you know, I think we're going to make another new low right down to the 200-day moving average in this trend line about 44.34. And we have this big gap all the way down here at 29.30 on Snap that has not been filled. So I think we're working our way down towards filling that gap is what I believe happening. Right now, you can see the resistance level about 54.88. This is where it traded. It held resistance several times, and we're right there at that level today. So I think it's likely we're going to get rejected here and start to make our new, you know, the next leg lower in Snap. I like this for more downside. Now, it is possible we run up and hit the top of this trend line, maybe get rejected up there. That is a possibility as well. AMD looks extremely weak, and I think AMD is going lower. So my target for AMD is about 59 bucks, and big negative divergence on AMD right there. You can see we've been trading in this big sideways trading pattern for quite some time, really going back to July of 2020. We've really gone nowhere, just sideways. Support is right here at 73.71. And you can see recently we ran right down to that support level. We hit it, started to bounce off of it. Pretty muted bounce though, really. You see the last time we hit the support, look through here. It's a little different right now. We hit support right there. Yeah, we muddled around it a little bit, then moved higher. The next time we hit support right here, big gap up, just impulsively, buyer stepped in impulsively. Again, right here, hit it, moved right high, you know, gapped higher the very next day. And here we've hit it and we haven't really been impulsively bouncing off of it. So again, the negative divergence that's intact tells me we're likely going to break down. And if we do, I think it'll be a swift move down to about 59 bucks. So that's the area that I'm looking to cover the trade. But I like this one, still looks good. Here's one that triggered today, Winnebago. You can see here that basically we have an uptrend line coming off of March 2020 lows, held support right here on the daily, held support all through here. We broke once, but we had this support level right below it, which you can see this horizontal support was right about 73.70 or so on this daily chart. That was resistance all through here. Once we broke above that, it was impulsive, big breakout candle. We came back in, and when we broke that trend line, that this vertical or this ascending trend line right here, we broke, but it ran right into that support and then bounced off of it. We have since broke that trend line again. So here's another sell signal right there. Came right down to the support, but this time today we're breaking down. We're breaking that support level, and it's impulsive so far. So we'll see how the day closes. But, you know, I think they're going to really have to step in and buy this thing up if it's going to recover this support level. If it continues to break and you get that sell signal, we've got levels. You know, we have a little bit of support right through here was the former peak. So we probably could mark that out, which is about 62.33. Looks like there's a little bit of support right here, right in there about 66. I think that looks good. I mean, from where that's at, it's a drop of, you know, 7, almost 8% down to 66 and about 12, 13% down to that target down there. So we'll see how that plays out, but I like it so far. Looking at some of these home builders, a couple things I want to point out. Here's XHB, which is the home builder ETF. This is the trend line that I got on the daily chart. So we have not broken trend, and we don't really have any negative divergence on the RSI. The PPO does have negative divergence, not really there on the RSI. We haven't broken trend. So in general, not an extremely bearish chart, but when I scroll through some of these home builders like Toll Brothers, you can see here coming off the March 2020 lows, we kind of held support through here. We broke, we got a sell signal right there. There's your breakdown, which did come on with negative divergence. You can see there's your negative divergence on the PPO and the RSI, and you got a sell signal, a back test, starting to roll over some more. So that's bearish in general. That's a bearish chart. That sets Toll Brothers up probably, first level of support looks to be right about there, 50, 55, and the 200-day moving average is right there. Going back, and then the next level of support is probably right about here. You can see we got a pretty good level right there at about 40.73. So those are key levels to watch. Looks like a good short. And then when I look at PHM, Pulte Homes, you can see we have this uptrend line right here. We got a sell signal right there. We're backtesting and starting to roll over. So it's very similar looking to XHB. So we're seeing some weakness in some of these home builders. We don't see it across the broad home builder ETF, but some of the home builders are starting to set up bearish. So something to keep an eye on. Okay guys, that's all I really got for today. So there's trade ideas. There's kind of my general analysis. Again, leave me a thumbs up on your way out. Check out the course if you haven't done so already, and I will catch you guys on the next video. Bye.